Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss the different functions present inside the character class. Okay. So first function that we will see is digit, then there is letter, then is letter or digit, then is white space. And then we have is lower case, is upper case, and then we have two lower case and two upper case. So these are the different methods present inside the character class that we are going to discuss. Okay, so is digit. Okay, so is digit function present inside the character class. Okay, it requires a character input and its return type is true or false. Okay, that is boolean. If the character that we give to it as a parameter, if it is a digit, it will return true, else it will return false. Next function is letter. So it takes a character input, and if it is an alphabet, it will give the return type as true or false. Then the third function is letter or digit. That means if the character given to it as a parameter is a letter or a digit. Okay, that means if it is alphabet or a digit, then it will return true, else it will return false. And then we have is white space. So this is white space checks whether the character here is a new line, okay, or a space, or it may be a new line. Okay, so all these three are known as white space. Okay, so okay, I made a mistake. So whether the character is a new line, or it may be a tab backslash t, or if it's a space. So all these three are known as white spaces. Okay, so if it is any one of these three, then it will return me true, else it will return me false. So let's see a sample program here. So in CH1 I have got a character 9, in CH2 I have got character Z, in CH3 I have got a percentage sign, and in CH4 I have got a space. Okay, now I am calling the isDigit function inside the character class, and I am passing CH1. CH1 is storing character 9, so character 9 is digit, it's a digit, so therefore it will print it is a digit, else it will print it's not a digit. So here 9 is a digit, so it will print it's a digit. Then CH2 I am passing to is letter. This is letter function checks whether it's an alphabet or not. So Z of course is an alphabet, so it will print Z is a letter. Then CH3, okay, CH3 which is storing the percentage sign, I'm passing it to is letter or digit. So this percentage sign is neither alphabet nor a number. Okay, therefore it will be, the condition here will be false. So since it is false, it will print CH3, that is the percentage sign is not a letter or digit, as it has done here. Okay, and then the last variable CH4 is storing a space. Okay, So that CH4 variable I'm passing it to is white space function, and since it is a space, it will return true. The is white space function will return me true. So the condition is true, and it is going to print space is a white space character. Okay. Now to determine the case of the character, whether it's uppercase or lowercase, we have two functions: is lowercase and is uppercase. Okay. So let's see the program for it. Here I've got small a in CH1 and capital B in CH2. So CH1 I'm passing it to is lowercase CH1. So CH1 is storing small a, therefore it is true, and hence it will print that a is a lowercase letter. Similarly, here is uppercase CH2. So CH2 is storing capital B, therefore the condition here is true, and this one will execute. It will print capital B is an uppercase letter. So if I pass CH2 here, the value that will be returned by this is lowercase will be false. Okay, and it will print that here we'll have CH2. Okay, that CH2 is, that is capital B is not a lowercase letter. So let me write it down. Character dot is lower case, and here if I pass CH2, so this will return me false. And then we have two more functions: two lowercase and two uppercase. Okay, again in the character class only. So we can use these functions to convert from lower to uppercase or from upper to lowercase. So here is a sample program. In CH1 I have got the character G, capital G, and in CH2 I have got a small d. So here you can see I am printing original letter and CH1. Value of CH1 is capital G, so it got printed as capital G. Then here I've printed letter after converting to lower case, so this gets printed as it is, and then we are passing CH1 to lower case. Okay, so this function will return me the converted case, that is small g. Okay, so here you can see the output is small g. So the return type of to lowercase is character, as you can see in the prototype given here. Okay, similarly to uppercase, its return type is also a character. So here if we see in CH2 we have got a small d. Now this I am passing to uppercase, so it will convert it to uppercase, as you can see here. Okay, and if you pass a capital letter to this function to uppercase, then you will get the same value, and same rule applies here also. If you pass a small letter to this to lowercase, you will get the small letter itself. Okay. So let's see this program. Write a program in Java to accept a string in lowercase, okay, and change the first letter of every word to uppercase. Okay, and then we have to display the new string. So the sample input is given here. Everything is in small letter. Here you can see we are in cyber world, and the output is So all the first letters of every word is converted into capital. Okay, and this question came up in the year 2018. So let's see this, how it can be done. So first I have declared a scanner object by the name of scanner, and then a message is displayed, enter a string, and then on the next line using the scanner object, next line function, we take the input string in the variable input, which is of string type. Then I make a variable output which is of string type, and it is initially empty. And then we start a loop which will go from 0 till the length minus 1. Okay. So what will be the length? The length of the input string, if we consider that the input is VR in cyber world, the length will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. The length is 20. So the length is not 20, I'm sorry, the length is 21. Okay, here you can see the length of the given string is 21. So the last index will go up till 20. Okay, now we extract here the value of the condition is 0 is less than 21. Okay, so the character at 0 index is extracted and stored in current character variable. Okay, now here we have got a condition, if I is equal to 0. Okay, if I is equal to 0, then that means the value of I is 0, condition is true, the second condition will not be checked. Okay, and the control will come here because the condition is true. Okay, and what will happen, the first letter, okay, the first letter will be converted into a capital letter. So whatever letter is there, in this case we have W, so that W is converted into an uppercase letter. So this two uppercase returns me a character. That character is concatenated into this output string. Okay, the output string that was created here. So here you can see we have written output is equal to output plus the return value of this. So the return value of this will be the character W. That W will be concatenated into output string. So now the value of output variable is W after the loop has executed one time. Okay, then I will be updated to 2, condition becomes 2 is less than 21. Okay, control comes inside and I value is 2. So the second character at index, sorry, the value of I is not 2 this time. Last time it was 1, last time it was 0. So this time it will become 1. Condition becomes 1 is less than 20. Okay. So the value of I is 1. Okay, so the character at 1 index is E. Okay, small e, that small e is extracted and stored in the variable current char, and then control comes here, if I is equal to 0, so this condition is false, I will not be 0 now. Okay, and this function call is made here. Okay, the call is made to charAt function. Okay, So to this caret function, we are passing 1 minus 1, okay? So 1 minus 1 will give me 0, right? So what is the character at 0? The character at 0, is it a space? It's not a space. Therefore, this condition is false. Both the conditions are false. So this one will not execute and this one will execute, okay? So this E, current character is storing E, that E will be concatenated to output. Output has already got W, okay? So in that W, E will be concatenated, okay? So we have V now, okay? Now the third character, okay, that is I will become 2. 2 less than 21, condition is true, control comes inside. So we are extracting the character at index 2. Index 2 has got a space. So here you can see that the index 2 has got a space. So since it's a space, okay, so current character will store a space, okay. Now this one is also false and this one is also false, okay. Here the value of I is what? 2. 2 minus 1 is 1, okay. So char at 1. Char at 1, is it a space? So at 1 we do not have a space. Okay, so both the conditions are false and this one will execute and that space will be concatenated to output. Output has already got V, okay, and to this string the space is concatenated. So the output string becomes V and then space, okay. Now the value of I will become 3. So 3 less than 21, condition is true, control comes inside, and this time the extracted character will be, it will be A, okay, the extracted character will be A. So that A is stored in current char, control comes here, and now I is equal to 0, this is false. See, I will not be 0 now, isn't it? So we'll not check this condition again, okay. Now this char at function is called again, okay, and this time 3 minus 1, okay, I represents the current index and minus 1 will give me the previous index. So the previous index, if it has a space, then what should I do? I will convert the current character, the current index character that is stored in current char. So currently, so this is the current index, okay. In this index I have got A, okay, and the previous index has got a space. That means what? Any character after space should be capital, right? That is what we are supposed to do. So we are checking the value. I is 3 right now, and we are checking the previous index by doing 3 minus 1. Okay, so char at 3 minus 1, that is 2. If it's a space, then I will convert the character which is stored at index 3 into capital. Okay, and that is what is happening here. So this condition is true, okay, previous index has a space. So the current character, that is in this one we have got small a, this small a is passed to 2 uppercase, okay, and that small a will be converted to capital A and concatenated to output. In output we already have V and a space, and then capital A is concatenated. So I think by now you should understand, you have got the logic, okay. So the logic of the program is like this. you check the current character. If the previous index, if the previous index of this character has got a space, then you'll convert this character into capital. Similarly, when the value of I is 7, so 7 minus 1 will give me 6. At index 6, we have got a space. Okay, that means this I will be converted into capital and then concatenated to the output string.